Good morning, everyone. Let us start this practical session. So during the last session, we started with the AutoCAD 2020 software. We have seen the user interface, then various menus, toolbars, and we have seen some of the basic draw commands. So you can observe here. So this is your toolbar. You can observe various tools. So first toolbar, it is for the draw toolbar. So we can draw any object by using the commands available on the draw toolbar. Okay, so we have seen the line, then polyline, circle, and arc command. Okay, also we have seen the polygon command. So just I will repeat that part, how to use this command. You can note down these steps. So if you want to use the line command, that means if you want to draw any line segment, then just click on the line command. So it is a left click from your mouse. Select the line command. Then you can see one cross on the screen. Okay. So here you can observe the command specify the first point. Okay. And you can see the two numbers. So these two numbers are nothing but the X and Y coordinate. So you can directly enter X and Y coordinate from the keyboard. Okay. Suppose I want X and Y coordinate at 100 and 100. So X coordinate is 100 mm and Y coordinate is 100. So just type here 100. Then to change the position, that means to select the Y coordinate, just press the tab button. So we can shift to the Y coordinate and again enter it 100. Then press enter. So in this way, you can get the okay, so this is your X and Y coordinate. So line is starting from the 100, 100. And now you can specify the length of that line and also the angle. So suppose we want the length as a 500 mm. So you can enter here 500. So enter the length of the line 500, then press tab button and specify the angle. Suppose I want the angle as a 40 degree. So in this way, you can draw the line segment. Okay. Now to escape from the previous command, right now line command is active. So you can see the next segment starting from the last point of the first segment. Okay. So to exit from the first command, you can press the escape, press the escape key. So you can exit from the command. Now next command is the polyline. So polyline is if you draw any object with the polyline command, okay, and if the object is divided into the number of segments, then all the segments, they are treated as a single object. So you can see the difference between a polyline. So for the polyline, procedure is same. Just click the different points on the screen. So you can get the required polygon. Okay. Now if you select this, then you can see complete object is selected. And if you draw the object by using line command, then you can see the difference. So if I select this, only single line is selected. Okay. So this is the difference between a polyline and the line command. So to draw the line, first procedure is enter the point, or second is just click anywhere on the screen. That is the required location. Suppose I want to start the line from this point. So select the first point. So this is your first point. And if I want the second point here, so click here. This will be your second point. Okay. Then you can press the escape. So this is how you can draw the line. Similarly, you can draw the polyline, then circle. Then next command, it is the arc command. So we have seen how to use the arc command. So there are different types of arcs available. 3-point arc. Then start, center, end. So you can refer the previous video. So for the polygon, we have seen how to draw a pentagon, how to draw a hexagon, how to draw a rectangle. Okay. So the next command, that was the ellipse. Okay, so ellipse. So we can see the three types of ellipse. One is a center, then axis end, and next is the elliptical arc. Okay, so first select the center ellipse. So for the center ellipse, you can read here, create an ellipse using a specified center point. Okay, so if I click here, then we have to specify the center point. Okay, so just I will draw a line. So I want to start the ellipse from this center point. So click here. This is your center point of the ellipse. Specify the end point of the axis. So for the ellipse, you know, there are two axes. One is the major axis and second is the minor axis. Suppose this is the first end point of the first axis. And the second end point that we will select as a minor axis in the y direction. So you can click here. So I have drawn these two lines as a reference for the major axis and for the minor axis. So this is how you can draw the ellipse. So this is by using center command, that is a center ellipse. Second type of ellipse is axis and the end. Okay, that means we have to just specify the axis end point. So I will draw another line. So select the line. So this is just a reference line. Now select the ellipse command, axis end. So you can read here, create an ellipse or an elliptical arc. So select the first end point. So you can read here, specify the axis end point of the ellipse. So I'm clicking here, specify the second end point. Okay. And now we have to select the third endpoint. Okay. So with the help of the same command, you can even draw the circle. So you can see here. So if the major axis and the minor axis both are same, then it will become a circle. Okay. So this is how you can increase or decrease the length of the minor axis. So just click for the required length. Suppose I want that length as a 75. You can enter directly 75. From the keyboard and then press enter. Okay, so this is the ellipse by using axis and the end point. Now if you want the elliptical arc, so for the elliptical arc, select the third command, elliptical arc. Okay, click there. Now read the command, specify the axis end point of the elliptical arc. So select here. This is the first end point. You can select here, second end point. Now select the, specify the distance to the other axis. That means we have to select the minor axis. So procedure is, first part is we have to create the ellipse. Okay, so it is the same procedure for the first center ellipse. Okay, so I'm clicking here for the minor axis, and after that you can read here, specify the start angle. So you can directly click for the start angle, or you can give the value of that angle. So right now that value is 0, so you can click here directly, and then you can see here, we can create the ellipse at the required angle. Okay. So as I move the cursor on the screen, we will get the different angle. You can complete the ellipse, or you can draw the elliptical arc at the specified angle. So just enter the required angle. Suppose I want the ellipse or elliptical arc at 120 degree. So type here 120 degree, then press enter. So we will get the arc at 120 degree. So you can check this, whether it is 120 degree. Okay, so you can see here, this is exactly 120 degree. Suppose we want the elliptical arc at 270 degree. So just draw one line as a reference line. Again, select the elliptical arc. Specify the axis end point. So read the command. So click here. Click the second point. And then click the minor axis. Now specify the starting point. Suppose we want the starting point at the y axis. So right now I don't have any reference point here. So just I'm clicking anywhere arbitrary. And then you can complete the ellipse at a 270 degree. Okay. So this will be exactly 270 degree with respect to the positive x axis. So this all angles are available with respect to positive x axis. Okay. So this is how you can complete the elliptical arc. So now here the next command that you can see, it is the hatch command. That means if you want to give a color to the particular part of the object, okay, then you can use this command that is called as a hatch command. So basically this command is used in the orthographic drawing where if you cut any object, okay, then the cut portion is shown by the hatch region, that is called as a hatching. Okay. Okay, so just consider I have drawn one hollow cylinder. So this hollow cylinder, you can see there is one hole at the center. Okay, and if you take one imaginary plane, so this is the imaginary plane. Okay, so if you cut this cylinder exactly in the vertical direction, okay, then you can observe the front view as, so I will draw the front view. So we'll observe this complete rectangle, okay, in the front view, and there is a hidden portion. So after you cut this by using cutting plane, then that hidden portion will be visible to the observer. So that will be so this is the line which is corresponding to this point, and this is the second point. Okay, so these two edges will be visible if you cut this cylinder by using this cutting plane. Okay, now this part which is actually cut by the cutting plane, it is shown by the hatching portion. Okay, so let us see how to use the hatch command. So select here hatch. Now you can read here, pick the internal point. Okay, so click here, then press enter. So you can see here hatching portion. Again click. Now click the internal point. Okay. Now you can change the hatching region, okay, or the hatching symbol. So you can see here the various patterns are available. So we can select the appropriate pattern. So most commonly used for the hatching, if you cut any object by using a cutting plane, then it is a ANSI, that is ANSI 31. So select this. So you can see the corresponding pattern. Now, if you want to edit the particular pattern, suppose I want to change this pattern, then double click here. Okay. And the select the required rig. So I am selecting again ANSI 31. So now you can see the hatching region. Okay. So now just by observing the first geometry, this is a three dimensional and this two dimensional view. Okay. So this view, it will represent the cut section of this hollow cylinder. And this hatching region, it shows that it is actually cut by the cutting plane. Okay. And this is your hollow region. So this is the use of hatch command. Instead of this hatching, that is the inclined line, you can directly give the color. So we will see how to give that color. So if you draw a circle and if you want to color this circle, so select again hatching, pick the internal point, and here select the solid. Okay. So you can see here color is white, so you can change that and you can take the required color. So this is how you can color the geometry. So with the help of this hatching command, if you create any picture in the AutoCAD software, okay, then you can color that picture by using this command. So this is the use of hatch command. So click here. Now you can see the remaining commands. So here, the two commands are spline. One is a spline fit and second is the spline CV. Okay. So spline CV is the control vertices and it is the fit point. Okay. So I will use the first command. So you can write down this command, spline fit. So click here, spline fit. So what is the use of that spline fit command is, if you have number of points, okay, on your drawing paper, okay, or on the screen, then you can draw a smooth curve by using that spline command. So for that, we will need some points. So I will draw the points by using the line command. Okay, so I have created the locus of points. So you can see here, these end points, we want to draw a smooth curve passing through the end points. Okay, so for that, we will require the spline command. So select this first command, spline. And now you can read here, specify the first point. So select the first point, then next point, you can read. Select the next point, then select next point. So just go on selecting the remaining points. So from all these points, you can draw a smooth curve. And lastly, select the point. Don't move the cursor. If you move the cursor, then it will change the shape. So you can observe here. Okay, so it is changing the shape. So once you get the required shape, then just click and then press the enter button. So you will get this smooth curve. Okay. So again, I will explain this how to draw. So if you want the curve from these endpoints, then select again. Spline command. Select the first point, second point. So select the remaining points. And just enter for the last point. So you will get this required smooth curve. Okay. So this is the use of spline command. You can draw a smooth curve. So basically this command is used to create the artistic view. Okay. So suppose we want to draw a glass bottle. That is the exterior or outline of the glass bottle. Then you can draw this with the help of this spline curve. So I will explain how to draw it. So just draw ellipse. And now we want to draw the smooth curve here. Okay, so here you can take draw this line as a reference line to create the shape of the bottle. And from this endpoints of that line, you can draw this smooth curve. Okay. So let us see how to draw that smooth curve. So you can take this line command. Now start here. So this is your starting point. Select this point. Now select all the remaining points that you have taken as a reference. So now you can see the shape. Just click enter. Okay. So this is how you can create the shape of the bottle. So you will need a curve. And now just mirror this. So you will get the complete shape. Okay. So I will explain the mirror command afterwards. Okay. So in this way, you can use a spline command to draw the continuous curve. Now, next command, it is the spline CV. So it is similar to the first command. Just with the help of the vertices, we can control the shape of that spline curve. Okay. So I will draw some vertices. And now you can draw a smooth curve by taking the vertices as a reference point. So select here, spline. Now just click at the vertices. So you can see here how the shape is changing if I select the vertices. Okay. So if I select the next vertices, so we'll get the shape like this. Okay. So basically the shape of this curve, it is controlled with the help of the vertices. So basically these vertices, they will create one line segment, and that line segment will try to remain tangent to that curve. Okay. So last, press enter. So we will get the required curve. Okay. So this is the second way you can draw this spline curve. This I will explain once again. If you want some reference, then you can draw the reference line. and now select the spline command, that is a spline cv. So click the first vertices. So in this way, you can create the spline curve by using the vertices. Okay. And then you can delete the reference geometry if it is not required. So in this way, you can draw the spline curve. Okay. So these two commands, they are required when we want to draw a smooth curve from the given set of points. So after that, there are two commands. One is a construction line and second is the ray line. Okay. So these two commands we will use mostly for the orthographic drawing. Okay. So from your theory part, we have seen the projection of point and projection of line. Okay. So when you draw that projection, basically we are drawing the views, that is a front view, top view, or the side view. Okay. And when you draw these views, you divide the drawing paper into four quadrant, first, second, and third, fourth quadrant. Okay. So for that, you will need XY line and then X1, Y1. Okay. So when you divide, similarly, you have to divide this screen when you draw the orthographic drawing. Okay. So for that, you will use the construction line that will completely divide this screen into four quadrant. So how to use that command? So construction line, it is a line with the infinite length. You can read here. It creates a line of an infinite length. So you can read it such as the X line, that means XY and the X1, Y1. So click here for the construction line. And just you have to specify the two points. We will not give any dimension. So whenever you use the construction line command, just click here ortho mode. Okay, so you can on the status bar. So this is the status bar. You can see here the 90 degree symbol. If you take the cursor on that symbol, then you will get the ortho mode. So what is the use of ortho mode is it can only draw the line in the vertical direction or in the horizontal direction. You cannot draw any line in the polar direction, that is any other angle. So just activate that. So this blue, it represents, it is activated. Now select the construction line. Now just click any two points. So select the first point. So this is your first point. Just move the cursor horizontally. So you can see the complete line. Click anywhere on this line. Okay, so this will be your second point, and then press the enter. So in this way, you can draw the construction line in the horizontal direction. Now you can see this line, it is an infinite line. So if I use the pan command, that means if I move the screen completely, so this is the pan command, you need to press the scroll button from the mouse and then move the mouse. So you can see it is an infinite length. Okay. Now similarly, again select the construction line. Now select the vertical point. So select the first point. Now just move the cursor in the downward direction and select the second point. Do not give any length for this line. Okay. And then press enter. So in this way, we can divide the given area, that is the drawing area, into four quadrant, and then we can start with the orthographic views. So you can draw here front view, then you can draw top view here, and you can draw the side view. Then next line, it is the ray line. So ray line, basically it is used for the projection lines. So in the orthographic projection, you must have seen, we take the reference line from the front view and side view, and then you can complete the top view. Okay. or you can take the projection line from the front view to complete the top view. So these lines we can draw with the help of the ray line. So let us see how to draw that. So suppose I have a front view as a rectangle and I want the reference in the top view. So you can use that construction line, sorry, ray line. So before that, just change the color. So you can see here in the properties panel, so you have the color option. So you can select the color of the line. So I'm just taking red as a reference line. So right now red color is active. So select the ray line. So just click here, ray line. Ray line, it is also an infinite line, but it has a starting point. Okay. So on both the side, it is not an infinite length. On one side, length is infinite. So we have to select the starting point. So I'm selecting this as a starting point. I will take the projection downward so I can draw the top view and just give the direction. Okay, so now you can see it is an infinite line in the downward direction. So if I move it continuously, so there is no end point. Now similarly, you can take the reference for the side view. So again, select the ray line. From this point, you can take the reference on the right side. So you can draw the side view. So once you complete